A very good evening to you all. This video is for class 8. Yesterday we have uploaded the video on the different topic of the reproduction in plant. We have uploaded the video of pollination. Now today we will see about artificial pollination and fertilization. So this is also part of reproduction in plant. What happens here is, first we will see artificial pollination. Artificial pollination means man-made pollination. Here what happens in artificial pollination, let's say we, the human being, will select a better variety of male plant and a better variety of female plant. Means one male plant will be selected and one female plant will be selected. Better variety. Let's say the male plant is very much disease resistant and the female plant is very much high yielding. Now what we will do, the pollen grain of the male plant we will collect and we will pour that pollen grain, we'll put that pollen grain in the stigma of the female plant which is high yielding variety. So male plant was disease resistant and female plant was the high yielding variety. So male plant is disease resistant, female plant is high yielding variety. Now when the pollen of the male plant, male plant's flower pollen grain, when the pollen grain will be given to the female part of the plant, that is the female flower, means the male plant, male flower, pollen grain will be collected from male plant, male flower, and it will be given to the female plant, female flower. Correct? Now, what happens here is, the pollen grain from the male flower will be collected and it will be given to the female flower. Now the male plant is disease resistant and female plant is high yielding variety. So the progeny what will come out will have both disease resistant as well as high yielding variety. This is also known as hybridization. So we can write here hybridization. Hybridization means the technique done by the human being. The technique done by the human being, that is by the artificial pollination. I hope you understand this. Next one is the fertilization. Here we need to be extra careful. What happens? I have made a rough diagram of the female reproductive system of the plant, female reproductive system of the flower. Means the flower female reproductive system has been made here. What happens when the pollen grain, will come here? When the pollen grain will sit on the stigma, this is the stigma. When the pollen grain will sit on the stigma of the female flower, this pollen grain will be offered with sugary syrup by the stigma. Means the stigma will offer the sugary syrup to the pollen grain. And finally, the pollen tube will form. This pollen tube will have the male gamete within itself. The pollen tube will be carrying the male gamete within itself. Now what will happen? This male gamete, which is present in the pollen tube, will slowly enter the ovary of the female reproductive part. There the male gamete will be discharged. There the male gametes will be given. Means the male gametes will be introduced in the female ovary by the help of the pollen tube. Now here two things we need to understand. One is about the DF, that is double fertilization. Another one is TF, that is triple fusion. Double fertilization, triple fusion. We need to understand what happens here. Till here I think it's clear. The pollen grain has sat there, the stigma has offered the sugary syrup to the pollen grain, the formation of pollen tube did take place, and now what happened, this male gamete, the pollen tube will carry the male gamete, two male gamete. Now this two male gamete will slowly enter the ovary. There the process of fertilization will take place. Now we need to understand why it is called as double fertilization and why triple fusion. I have made one diagram here. We can see this diagram very properly. Here I have written egg cell at the top. Here egg cell, here polar nuclei, and here the antipodal cells. Egg cell, polar nuclei, and the antipodal cells. What happens here? Now, from here, the male gamete has entered the ovary. Inside the ovary, this kind of arrangement we shall see. egg cell, polar nuclei and antipodal cells. Now the male gametes which has entered, the male gamete will first fertilize this polar nuclei. One male gamete will fertilize this polar nuclei over here. Another male gamete will fertilize the egg cell over here. So, two male gametes are involved in the process of fertilization. Two male gametes involved in the process of fertilization. That's why first one is clear, double fertilization. Why? Because two male gametes were involved. Now, why it is known as triple fusion? Why it is known as triple fusion? Because polar nuclei will be two in number. Polar nuclei will be two in number. But the egg cell will be only one. We can see here two, but these two will be conjoined to form one. These two will be joined to form only one. So, what happens? One, two. Two polar nuclei and one egg cell. Total how many? Three. That's why triple fusion. I hope it's clear to you. Double fertilization, how did it take place? Because two male gamete fertilized two different female gamete. So double fertilization, understood, because only two male gametes were there. How triple fusion? Two polar nuclei in number and one egg cell in number. So 2 plus 1, 3. Very simple mathematics. That is triple fusion takes place. So I hope this is understood. Now, what are the post-fertilization event? What are the post-fertilization event? Here, the post-fertilization event will be that when the fertilization completes, post-fertilization means after fertilization, when the fertilization complete, formation of endosperm will take place. The ovary will mature to form the fruit. The ovule will develop or mature to form the seed. So, ovary will turn to fruit. Ovule will turn to seed. Then what will happen to the other whorls of the flower, that is calyx, corolla, stamen and all? They will all wither off. Wither off means they will fall off. They will fall off. Calyx, corolla, stamen, other parts will fall off. Ovary will turn into fruit, ovule will turn into seed. And if the fertilization by luck it is missed, if the fertilization does not take place, if the fertilization does not take place, then that fertilization will be considered as a fake fertilization. Fake fertilization, false fertilization. In that case, the flower will automatically shed off from the plant. The flower will automatically shed off with its calyx and corolla also. First the calyx will shed off, then the corolla will also shed off. If the fertilization by chance or by luck, if at all it is missed, then this process will happen automatically from the plant, the flower will shed off. I hope this video is clear to you. Please see the text and match my video.